G'day Bambies, Kaleido here, and welcome to a brand new Sims 4 building series that I'm going to be starting here on my channel called Micro Apartments. So this is very much inspired by the various videos that are here on YouTube of in real life renovations that people have done, and I was absolutely inspired by them to create them, I suppose, in The Sims 4 and vicariously kind of live through The Sims 4 in renovating my own, because, you know, I love building in The Sims, and I would love to get into interior design and other stuff like that in real life, but I'm not really at that stage yet in my life, so I do it through The Sims at the moment. Let me know down below in the comments if anybody else is like that. I actually heard a while ago when I was watching a Sims video, I think it was talking about the history of The Sims franchise, actually. They're saying how, like, back in the day, people used to use The Sims to plan out their, like, house or whatever. So, okay, that was just, like, a random fun fact there. But anyways, back to the video. I'm so happy to be starting this. I've been thinking about it for quite some time, and I want to be doing more building stuff here on my Kaleido channel. So, get ready for it, guys. And this one is renovating an entire sort of like a done up warehouse. So this is inspired by a lot of the various like warehouses that we have here in Melbourne. I'm not sure if they do this in other countries. I'm sure they do, but they're basically redoing up and reusing these old warehouses that aren't being used anymore for whatever reasons they were built. And this one is called Happy Llama Mills. There are 6 different apartments, I suppose you would call them, in here. Well, obviously the series is called Micro Apartments. But since we're in The Sims 4, we actually can't create separated apartments. It's something that I really miss about The Sims 2, and I'm not sure if we had that in The Sims 3, but I think we did. Correct me if I'm wrong, I didn't actually get to play The Sims 3 that much because it was just way too buggy for me. But I do recall we had apartments and stuff in The Sims 2. But unfortunately, we cannot create them separately in The Sims 4. What you can do, if you guys want to play this once I upload it, what I'll do is I will renovate each and every one of these 6 rooms or 6 apartments and in multiple videos, and then after the last one is done, we will upload the entire lot, and you guys can move in your Sims, and then what you do is you click on the door there and you lock out certain Sims, or you make it so then your Sim who lives there is the only one who's able to go in, and maybe you can pretend, do a little bit of roleplay, and your special someone, or maybe your best friend Sim, you could allow them to go through the door too, and pretend that it's like you're giving them your key or something like that. But yeah, so this build, well, this apartment has a loft bedroom, which I thought was really nice. This is something that I've always wanted in real life too. And the really good thing about the Happy Llama Mills is that we have these gorgeous giant windows, and they are absolutely stunning. I can imagine that they would let in so much awesome light, and it would feel like such a lovely creative space. So the person who lives here, I reckon, would be pretty creative. I'm not sure if they would actually use this studio or this apartment to work in, but they do have a computer upstairs, so they could do some work here. I think in one of the other apartments in this build, I might do a little bit more artsy, like a studio, but this one, I wanted to be more of a home kind of feel. So it's definitely very homey, lots of little bits and bobs around the place, and it looks very lived in. Now, something that I really love about warehouses is the exposed brick. So, of course, we wanted to have a lot of that just to kind of show the bare bones of the building, and that's something that people do a lot here in Melbourne, is just really let the building shine by showing like stuff like the bricks, or sometimes people even just like will have concrete floors and stuff. And you can see in some parts of this video when I go into the little lobby hallway that we do have exposed concrete out there, which is nice and polished. So in some of the other apartments, we possibly will leave concrete. I think that would be kind of cool to leave behind. But in this one, we are working with a lovely light timber flooring, and I think this goes really well. And when the light comes in the morning, it would be such a warm atmosphere, I feel like it would create. We have a big curved TV here on the wall, and I really, really wanted there to be an awesome lounge space that was just very, very comfy and inviting. So I work hard on that. I love, love how we have the kitchen over here. It's just like a little nook right there. And then I've built the bathroom to be right underneath the bedroom loft. So I guess like that's the only truly private part of the room. I would imagine that this would be a little bit higher off the ground, but since we're in The Sims 4, like I can't exactly do that. But I guess I could have made the foundation a bit taller, but it looked a bit strange when I did that. But right now, Sims can look through those windows pretty easily, but you know, it is The Sims, so I guess they can't actually, you know, it doesn't actually affect their privacy or anything like that. I really like how I use a lot of yellows, some reds and oranges, and also some little touches of green with the plants and turquoise. So I did a build the other day. It was the Tiny Homes Observatory, and we used a lot of these colors with the little pops of turquoise, and now I am hooked. I love, love all of the new rugs that we got in Jungle Adventure. They're so, so nice. And oh gosh, I definitely did put a lot of rugs in this build, so please don't mind that. It's actually inspired by, I can't remember which model it is, but she was a model and it was like a Vogue video or something. Oh gosh, I can't believe I can't remember this. I'm terrible at remembering names, but she was giving a tour of her studio apartment, and it was absolutely stunning. It was very similar to this space, although it didn't have a loft bedroom. And oh my gosh, I just loved how she had rugs everywhere, just like so many different ones overlapping. And I think that's something that I probably will do a lot in this series, and it's something that I tend to do anyways in my, like, it's just something that I do in my building style in The Sims. And I kind of think it brings a different type of feel to the room too when you have multiple different rugs. Doesn't make it kind of boring, because if you have like a rug just straight up like aligned to the rest of the furniture, I feel like it can definitely make the room feel a little bit too perfect. Sometimes it's good to have some variation, and it's good to not have everything, you know, perfect and lined up. So that's just my preference. I know some people have commented in the past saying like, could you please straighten up those rugs? And sometimes I feel like straightening them up, but other times, and this is one of those other times, most times, I like to decorate with them on a weird angle. No idea why. So because I reckon this would be a rental, and it is a little bit difficult to hang up paintings and stuff on brick walls, because obviously it's a hard brick wall with concrete, what you would have to do is like drill a hole into it, like a, and then put in, oh gosh, I only know this because my dad and I did like a little DIY project. We put like pot plants on the side of our brick house when I was little. It just stuck in my head that it was actually harder than I thought to put something hanging onto a brick wall. So I thought with that, all that wisdom and knowledge that I have attained, I would try to make the room feel a bit more realistic and maybe have less of the paintings hanging up on the walls and more of them just laying against the wall, because it would be way too troublesome. And maybe the landowners, since it's probably a rental, wouldn't like it with if you were drilling a ton of different holes into the walls. And it is very hard to stick anything onto exposed brick. Like, usually it will be like a bit chalky and something, so those Velcro stick-on hooks probably wouldn't work that well. I have no idea, I haven't actually tested them out, but I have a feeling they would not work out very well. Or if they do, I would not trust them. Like, I would not with my life, because they probably will lose their adhesive after an hour or two and fall off. But yeah, so we have two mirrors out here. I wanted there to be some little different sections. So we obviously have the tiny little entranceway with the front door. I do add in a little cupboard there and a little table. And there's also like a coat hanger and a little hat rack, which is nice on the wall. And then you're straight away into the lounge room. So I used the new, my first pet stuff lounge and mixed it with a long ottoman to make like sort of a L lounge. I think that worked out quite nicely. And then we have two armchairs, which I think one of them, the person would have saved up a lot of money to buy that yellow armchair. And then the, red one may have been something they found at a garage sale or maybe on the side of the road. There's a lot of that here in Melbourne. I actually, the other day, this is a couple months away actually, I saw a really nice, I think fake leather, but it probably was real leather, lounge. It was like a proper huge lounge and it looked so good, and somebody just had it on the side of the road. So kind of just going off Melbourne vibes here, where like stuff you find on the side of the street are actually good quality. But yeah, so we have the ottoman, which kind of like splits up the space. And then we have a nice little shelving system there with some bits and bobs that they would need, you know, towels and stuff, and a lovely big mirror for them to check how they look in the morning before they go off to work. So yeah, it's a nice little space before they go up into the bedroom, and lots of little pot plants in here. I put lots of hanging things too, because I absolutely am obsessed with those new Jungle Adventure pot plants. Oh my god, it actually took everything in me not to add in more, but I thought if I added more than two, it might have been overkill. So I know they're gigantic, but honestly, they are so cool. Don't hate me, guys. I'm not going to put pot plants in every single apartment. I swear I'm going to try to do each and every one of them in a different style. I promise. But this one's such a Angeline style. Like, this is totally something that I would love to have. It's just so homey, so open. I really like that you could sit up in bed and then just like look over, and if you had visitors, you could just like chill up there and they could be downstairs watching TV or whatever. Or maybe you have somebody cooking away in the kitchen and then somebody could be in the lounge room watching a movie. And I just really like this whole thing of inclusivity. Is that a word that I'm trying to say? But I like that everything's all basically in the same space. And oh, I totally forgot to mention, this is an 8x8 room too that we're building in. So it is quite small, and all of the rooms except for two are 8x8 in this lot. The other two are 7x8, so they're just one smaller by their width. And I think that's going to be really normal in this series. We're going to be trying to work with very small, tiny spaces and probably more working with the height. But we'll see how we go. Not every single one of these apartments are going to be having a loft space. We might even work with basements. I have no idea. I really want to get creative with this series. So let me know, guys, if you're excited for this. I really am. I think I'm going to be able to get super creative with interior design in this, and just work with a whole bunch of different styles and things. Of course, I'm going to need you guys' help. So comment down below what type of style you would like to see in one of the other, in one of the other apartments, because there are 5 more in this lot. But after we finish this lot, we'll go ahead and renovate another building, which will have its very own apartments. Maybe we'll do some different types. Like obviously this building, Happy Llama Mills, has been renovated and sectioned out to be used as like rentals and stuff. While I feel like it would be cool to do a rundown building in the future and really like challenge myself a bit and do some different out there things. But we're starting off with easy peasy because, you know, it's a new series. I'm really, really happy to be doing this though. It's been on my mind for quite some time. So now we're doing a cute little bathroom here, and I wanted to have a shower and a bath in here, and I try to make this kind of a high-tech but kind of bohemian-like bathroom. And oh gosh, I know that I was such a skeptic of laundry day stuff, but I thought it made it feel more like an apartment with having a dryer and washing machine in here, so we included that. We don't have a dishwasher in here though. I actually think I've started building without dishwashers recently. I've just totally forgotten they exist in the game at all. So maybe in a more modern, sleek version of an apartment in this place, we can do a dishwasher. But yeah, I really like this tiny little bathroom here. It has everything you need and more. I think this would be entrepreneur or maybe even like a business person's sort of house for them to come back to. They're obviously not thinking about family or anything like that. Of course, in a one-bedroom place like this, you would not be thinking about having kids. Especially with that very dangerous staircase there, which I didn't add on a railing only because I don't like railings on staircases in The Sims. I don't know why, they just look really crowded. I probably should just add it. I might add that. Now that I'm thinking about it, maybe I'll just add it for realism. But we do have railing up the top because of course you don't want them to fall down. I wanted it to feel kind of industrial to match the building. So that's why it's kind of the mesh old stairs, and up the top it kind of looks like rusty metal railing also. This is sort of inspired by a couple of videos that I've seen around on YouTube. I love watching like tiny homes, and now I'm really into watching like apartment renovation videos here on YouTube too. And especially the ones that are here in Melbourne, the ones in Fitzroy, are just so cool. And oh god, I really, really want one, but they're so expensive. Buying real estate is so pricey here in Melbourne and Australia. I'm not sure how it is overseas, but damn, it is really pricey here. Oh well, that just means that I get to build more in The Sims and hopefully get some more videos out for you guys. But yeah, that's going to be it for this video. I hope you guys all enjoyed. I'm going to be releasing another one of these probably this week because I'm just so into it. I had so much fun renovating this little space, and I kind of want to do a artist studio, but let me know what your suggestions are down below. I'll be picking my favorites to do, and we have 5 more apartments to do in this building. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you all next time. Bye!